So what happened is I'm not very big on social media. Yes, I used to write a blog every day for 3 years. Then I myself got bored. I will restart. But recently I went to AdSense, the monetization engine of Google, by mistake. And it showed me a number, 3,40,000 or something like that. So I realized that I must have started some ad long back and forgot to stop it. So now this has piled up as a bill. Then I realized they owe me that money. Now, why did they owe me that money? I don't even remember enabling any monetization, never done an SEO. Then I realized I have published some videos on YouTube, around 80 of them, not a big number. I have not done anything for optimization or SEO, but that much was due over many years, not a short time. Over 5 years, I got 3 lakhs. Then I said, let me look at it seriously because I'm not billable every day. So it can be used, and that's how I learned it. Now, whenever I'm showing something, there is a disclaimer, another one, and when you try to do something, there is an important thing. Whatever you look at, please look at the date, because these rules, regulations, tips and tricks, everything which I'm showing change very often, and there is no clear announcement. So you really need to look at some reference which was 4-year-old, probably it's already outdated. So anything you do, look at recency. Now, in both Google and YouTube, when you go to filter, there is a recency filter. You should apply at least last year as the filter, if not last month. These are some stats. I'm not going to read them out. This is why YouTube has become more and more important as we go along. In practical terms, what are we going to use it for? Because we are not YouTube celebrities in that sense. All of us manage businesses. So from that context, any of these can be, one or more of these can be your objectives. Are there any companies here who are very active on YouTube channel corporate-wise? Anyone? Okay. So maybe you'll get some ideas, maybe some things which I'm telling you, you already know, but I'm going to give you a wide variety of things. Maybe some of it you know, some of it you don't know, you'll find it useful. So primarily, if you look at what people put on YouTube, most of it is junk, by the way, but practically, it is training or entertainment, some other minor categories. Now, when you want to use YouTube, you need a Gmail account. You can't do anything on YouTube without a Gmail account. But first thing you have to do is create a brand channel. I'm talking, assuming that you're going to use this for corporate context. So you create a brand channel. It can be private or public, so you can only expose it to your customers or even internal employees. You can use it for training your field staff, whatever it is, only by invitation, or it can be public. Similarly, when you put a video, there are 3 categories. The default now is unlisted. Private means you have to specify names of people by using a YouTube or Gmail email ID and invite people. Only those people can see it. They will have to log in. Public means anybody can see it. Unlisted means anybody whom you share a link with can see. Now that link can be forwarded to someone, they will also be able to see. Unlisted only with a link, but they don't have to log in. So that's the default when you upload a video. There are 2 upload methods. The default is unlisted. Now, never whether you use optimization of YouTube or not, doesn't matter. I'm sure you watch videos on YouTube. So these are some of the shortcuts you should remember. Arrow keys, up, down, right, left. Left arrow goes back 5 seconds, right arrow goes forward 5 seconds. That probably you know. Up and down increase or decrease the volume. J and L go 10 seconds back and 10 seconds forward. What is 1, 2, 3, 4? Can anyone tell me? You're watching a video, you can type 0 to 9. What does that do? It goes, if you type 2, it goes to 20% of the video. If you say 5, it jumps to 50% length of the video. So it's a very quick way. Nowadays, people waste too much time on intro. You get irritated. So directly press 1, it'll go 10%. So it's a very quick way of navigation. F means full screen, M means mute. And very nice, when you're watching a video, you want to search for another video. You have to take the mouse and click in the search box. So slash, like Lotus Notes, directly goes to search box. There are more shortcuts even. This much is good enough. Incidentally, nowadays, premium ad-free YouTube is free for 3 months. The promo is running. Everyone may not see that promo, but If you see it, use it. It's very nice. Now, when you create videos, it's a very complex process. I'm not going to go into the camera, lights, and the physical equipment which is involved. I'm talking about the video already being ready. Many of us are IT people. We use videos for training purpose where some screen recording has to be done. That is done using Snagit. If you want a quick video, if you want a high-resolution video, you use Camtasia. Nowadays, a lot of focus is on mobile apps. There are no web-based apps. There are only mobile apps. I'm sure all of you have some kind of mobile app. To give training of that mobile app, you'll have to record the screen of the mobile. The best software I have seen, I have been using it for 3 years, is MobiZen. MobiZen comes in multiple flavors. One is for screen sharing, so I can project my mobile on my screen. That's called MobiZen mirroring. And then there is MobiZen recording, which allows you to record a screen on mobile and save it as a video for further editing. Now, video editing, there are a lot of software. I'm not going to go into those. OpenShot and Lightworks are free. 3D graphics, Cinema 4D is paid. Blender and Unreal Studio is free. If you understand gaming, Unreal is a gaming software platform. They have a very sophisticated gaming engine. Now that gaming engine itself has been made free. So it's really, really sophisticated and complex, but very feature rich. 2D graphics, very often we need to create thumbnails and stuff like that. I'll show you how that is done. Remember, the Adobe has a free software called Spark, which is really nice. Because I may not have time later, let me just quickly show you what it does. So I'm going to go to Spark. Now in Spark, notice these are YouTube thumbnails. YouTube thumbnails are important. You can create a thumbnail like this. There are multiple options here for popular social media, so it understands what are the sizes, what is the layout, what is the aspect ratio. So you just put the content and rearrange the content. For example, if I want this content, I start with this, and then I can just play with it. You don't have to be a designer, but what you create will be better. If you like memes, this is the fastest way of making memes without doing any copy-paste, font size, color, like that. So now if you don't like this, there will be other design options. In one click, I can change the design options very easily. This requires internet connection. Probably it's slow, but you get the idea. Some part of it is free. If you need branding, only then you have to pay for it. So very quickly, you can create professional looking stuff. Coming back, audio editing, probably someone is already doing, so I won't go into that. So what we create is a channel. The name matters. It should describe the content of the channel because it's important for SEO. In a corporate context, when you create a brand channel, it's still linked to someone's Gmail ID. That person may not be handling the entire channel. There may be an agency involved. There may be multiple people involved. So once you have a brand channel, multiple people can be given admin rights and distribute the work. Now, what is happening in a channel? In a channel, typically you see popular videos, but you can have multiple things and you can arrange the order in which these things are adjusted. Generally, people go with the standard, look at the performance, and then tweak it. Most probably, the first row shows popular videos, which are the highest ranking or highest view count. Second row typically shows recent activity, but that's not a hard and fast rule. Of course, we have playlists also, which we'll come to later. Now, when we go to a channel, there is something called channel art, which is becoming increasingly important. Let me try to show you. This is a very sad example of channel art. This is my son, actually. Now, but this has very specific branding requirements in terms of dimensions. This sounds very large, but when you resize it or you see it on a mobile, it adjusts itself. It's responsive in some way. So you need to know these dimensions. It won't accept images beyond that. So, where was I? Are power itne bage? So playlist is very important because when you create a video, generally what happens, we just keep uploading videos and then it becomes jumbled up because there may not be nahi power nahi. Adho thode utakun hogam. फ्यूज उड़ल जा रहा है दूसरे प्लग में टक हाँ थैंक यू सो प्लेलिस्ट आर इम्पोर्टेंट द बेस्ट प्रैक्टिस इज व्हेन यू अपलोड अ वीडियो पुट इट इन अ प्लेलिस्ट इफ देर इज नो प्लेलिस्ट यू कैन क्रिएट इट देयर एंड देन व्हाई इज दैट इम्पोर्टेंट बिकॉज इफ अ वीडियो इज अ पार्ट ऑफ प्लेलिस्ट इट टिपिकली रैंक्स हायर एंड एज time progresses, I'm sure you will put videos which will fit into playlists. One video may fit into multiple playlists also. Playlist names should not be one word like Word, Excel, PowerPoint, or your product name. It should be descriptive. So use XYZ product efficiently is a better playlist name than just the product name. Now the whole thing is, how does a video rank? What becomes viral? There is an algorithm, obviously, which you are never going to know. And the best part is you don't have to bother about the algorithm. The concept is very simple. If you have created something which is interesting, as long as people get to it, they can be made to be interested throughout the duration of the video, then the content part is done. The second part is how will it attract people there? So that is where we have to work. So content itself is only 50%. Making people know this exists is the second half. So that is the whole idea. If people find the content, it will become viral. Don't start with the idea of creating a viral video. Create a useful video, promote it in the right way, and then whatever happens, happens. Sometimes nothing happens for years, and suddenly a video becomes viral. For example, I told you, I have 80 videos in my channel. I got some 3 lakhs rupees over 5 years. Out of that, 2.8 lakhs came from one video, which I had published 5 years back. That was a Power BI walkthrough video. I have seen that video 20 times. I have still not understood why that became popular compared to the remaining 79. So don't bother, create good content, life will happen. So video content quality, I'm not going to go into details, but many people spend too much time introducing their channel and how great they are. Don't do that, come to the point. People's patience is in seconds now, not minutes. So in the first 10 seconds, whatever is the topic, if you have not talked about it, people are going to go away. They will click outside. The average duration people see videos across YouTube is 10 seconds. So remember, annotations, they were very irritating. Boxes and callouts, they have been removed. Fortunately, they have been replaced with cards. We will see what that means. So audio quality, again, don't put too much music. Many people have extra music. Special effects like Saas Bahu serial, aisa kuch aega, beep, boop, don't do that. Focus on the content, unless it's an ad which you have put, which has its own SFX. Pure content is basically what you are showing, what you are talking. If music or special effects add value, do it. But many times sound engineers assume that there has to be a vocal track, there has to be a music track, there has to be a SFX track, and there has to be an ambience track. So in a serious video on project management, you don't want to see sparrows chirping at the background. It does not add value. So don't waste time. Video formats, all video formats are supported. In short, make sure your aspect ratio is 16:9. If it is not, some black bands will come above or on the side. VR videos and 3D videos are supported. Now, as we mature on the channel, channels have a lot of features. For example, each feature has some prerequisites. So in this particular example, many of the features are enabled. Now, by default, long videos are not allowed when you start a channel. Only 15 minutes is the limit. But when it reaches a particular number of subscribers or number of hours, that rule keeps changing. You click on learn more, you will know what is the current rule. Then you can load up to 12 hours of video. Like that, in my case, channel membership is not yet enabled because that requires 30,000 subscribers. I have only 11,000. So you have to monitor this to see what is enabled and make use of it. Now when you are uploading videos, what happens? A single video or bulk video, and you can put metadata along with it while you are doing it. As I said earlier, unlisted is the default. Why is unlisted the default? Because very often people upload the video, share the link with half the world, and then realize there was a spelling mistake. Once you upload a video, you can't change it. You can't change the content. You can trim it, that's all. So once you create a video and the URL is ready, there is no way to change it. The only method is delete, but you have already shared the URL. So to prevent that from happening, always upload video as unlisted. Let some third person do a quick proofreading kind of thing. Make sure it's good, then go up. Yes, sir, yeah, again, means time khatam, kitna? So basically, you can't change the video after publishing. In spite of whatever you do, you will make mistakes. So if you do make a mistake, what do? You can't delete it because the URL is already on your brochure or a TV ad, you don't know where. So what do? You go to the video, it is still editable in the sense you can trim it. So just keep first 20 seconds of the video and then add a card on top of it with a URL to the new version of the video. That's the only thing you can do. There is no way to redirect a URL, it's a permalink. But this is the workaround. Now, how to make a video popular, that itself is a long, long topic. But I have listed the most common things. Now, the easiest things to do in this is the first one. Just create good content. Don't bother about virality. And something which is completely ignored is thumbnail. Thumbnail is really important because how are people coming to your video? They are either directly been given a link, which is rare, or they searched for something and many videos came, or they were watching a video, some reference videos or related videos came. Whatever it was, there was a collection of videos. People look at the title, okay, maybe similar titles. The only method people choose a video is by looking at the thumbnail. So thumbnails are important. All others are also important, but I don't have time to go through each one of them. Now, what is also important is when you upload the video. Now, of course, if you upload a video randomly in once a month, it doesn't matter. But if you are seriously focusing on growing your YouTube popularity or you are using YouTube proactively, there has to be a predictable frequency. Because if there is a predictable frequency, people like it and their subscription rate goes up. Now, when I say schedule the upload, how do you know what is the best time? You think people look at your video at 11 o'clock. That's not the correct thing. People may look at it whatever time. So you go to Google Analytics. That actually gives you a sort of a heat map of time of day and number of views. Monitor that. And then when you upload a video, you can schedule a video. It should not get published now. It should get published in that ideal time frame. And that yields very good results. Also remember, some of your customers or target audience may be across time zones. So in my case, most people are either in India or US. So you have to choose one of them depending on the context. Video length, contrary to what we think, longer videos are better. So I have a video which is 11 minutes and I have a video which is 3 hours. Both are doing equally well. And sometimes the longer video has better pull. People may not have patience, but once they find something useful, there is no limit. They'll repeatedly come back to it and what in pieces also. Now, when it is a long video, table of contents is important. So I'll just show you this and another demo together. This is a video which we did yesterday. This is the video I published yesterday for the project management thing. Now, what is here? I have a description. Now, in the description, I have 4 topics covered. If you really want to go to a particular topic, you can just click on this and go there. This TOC is very important. Normally you don't see it. Mostly people will see the first paragraph, but believe me, people click on it and they expect a TOC. So long videos with TOC do really well. You have to follow that. Okay. So title has to be long. Short titles are bad. Use the keyword, for example, if I'm using project management, don't just create project management as the title. Put something around it. The keyword may be project management, but something around it. Maximum 100 characters. And whatever keywords you use, they should be there in the title, they should be there in the description, and the first 30 seconds of your video. Remember, all of you are using cognitive services. Where did it all originate? Search engines were the first places where AI originated. Because without a human being, they had to rank a page. So obviously, till recently, YouTube did not have a clue as to what you are speaking in the video till audio intelligence came. Now, obviously, everything is auto-transcribed, so it knows the word. So first thing it checks is, have you put a misleading title, force people to go there, and actually the title is not inside. That's cheating. So it looks for the keywords in the first 30 seconds. So make sure it's clearly spelled out. It does a transcript also. How do you know Google or YouTube understood it? You go to the transcript, see the transcript. If it is misspelled, you can even edit it. Thumbnails, as I said, are very important. These are two thumbnails which were ready-made in Spark. You can create thumbnails in any software. It's easier to make it in Spark or Canva. Most of my thumbnails I make in PowerPoint. It doesn't matter what you do. It should look good and attract the audience. Now, description has to be really descriptive. Never mind if anybody is going to read it. Description being lengthy convinces the algorithm that this person is serious. And of course, it should have the same content. So some words should match from the video as well as the text. And that increases ranking. That is what people say. It's empirical evidence. Similarly, tags have to be lot of tags, but not no cheating. Just because more tags, don't put tags which are not there in the video. But whatever is there in the video, think if someone had to find my video, they may even search how to do project management. I have not put how to as a tag, so ideally I should add a tag. So some amount of keyword research is involved in finding tags. Most of you will have an agency to do it, but even if there is an agency, you understand your business better than anyone else. You should monitor and refine what the agency does. Transcripts, as I said, are automatically created and they are completely editable. This is the transcript which was created for a similar session I did 2 years back. And that is completely editable if there are mistakes. If you want, you can upload your own transcript. If your target audience is multilingual, you can upload and you should upload multilingual transcripts, especially if it's a customer training or support site where multilinguality matters. Now, I said annotations are removed because they were irritating and people were misusing it. Instead of that, we have what is called as cards, which are more subtle. They don't trouble you. It comes and goes, and then it's there in the background. So what can you put in a card? You can put a video, a channel, a poll, and a link. When do you insert cards? Somewhere during the lifespan of the video. Now, a special type of card is called end screen. In the last 20 seconds by default, you can choose what to put there. So for this project management video, I have put another link to a video of mine and a link to my blog. You can customize this. There are multiple layouts available and it just works fine. You can customize the duration also. First, I want to show the video link for 15 seconds. 5 seconds later, I want people to go to blog. If I give them two calls to action, they will get confused. So simple common sense based thinking is involved. Now there is also a single associated website which can be mapped where you can put links within the video. Why is only single one required? Because people misuse it for doing random advertising. So if you do random advertising, Google's advertising revenue goes down. That is why whatever they are doing is to prevent you from cross advertising. That is why. That is why only one website is allowed, and that website needs to be technically verified by putting some HTML code in the header of your website to prove that you are the owner. But typically it is used for product microsites, homepage, like that. Now for managing this, there are a lot and lot of features. I'm not going to cover all of them. Some of them I have already covered, but there are two versions of this tool, Creator Studio and the older version. The Creator Studio has been perpetually in beta for years. So practically, some features are available in Classic, some are in Creator. If the same feature is available in both, typically the new version is better. But you can't discard the old version yet. You have to use mix and match. Promoting videos is basically all the things you already know, so I'm not going to talk about it. But one thing which people don't talk about is email signatures are under IT control. All of you have Exchange servers, email signature can be centrally controlled. So if you are doing a product launch and you have thousands of employees, nothing prevents you from putting a brand video for that product by globally changing the signature using group policy. That's a very easy and cheap or cost-effective mechanism to promote videos or any other URL, I mean. Now, how do you interact with users? Comments are important. Of course, many comments will be stupid. You can kick them out. But there are genuine comments, and you must respond to them. I'm not saying on a daily basis, but at some predictable frequency. People really like that. And the fact that you're reading comments and responding to them increases your ranking because it basically shows commitment. There is also a possibility of doing polls, which I recently did. So this will be visible to all the subscribers. Now, I'm sure a lot of YouTube videos nowadays is fashionable to have desperately begging you to do subscribe and click on the bell icon, all kinds of unnecessary 3D animation to tell you how to click on a bell icon as though we are dumb. Don't do that. People are smart. If they like it, they will click. Don't push them. So subscribe, after subscribe, bell, and then it is done. Hi, hi. Thanks. Okay. Now there is another thing which is commonly not known. On a long-term basis, subscription is most important, assuming you have a long-term plan. Now, subscription button is visible only when you're not full screen or at the end of the video. But there is a way by going to branding, settings, channel branding, where a subscribe button, which is customizable, it's a one-by-one aspect ratio, can be visible throughout the video. This increases engagement. It doesn't disturb the audience. Where is that video? Where is that? Let me show you. So if I have a video running, let me go to a video. Now as the video starts, this is the button. This is always there. If I go there, it will say subscribe, otherwise it will keep quiet. This is a very subtle but very effective way of increasing subscriptions. Now I don't have time to give you examples. I was just researching some good and bad sites. So Philips and Tata Motors are really nicely managed. I'm not saying they're the best, but from whatever I saw, these stood out. Now, what do you think? Amazon will have a good YouTube site or bad YouTube site? Good or bad? Wrong. They have absolutely pathetic YouTube site. They don't want anybody to go to YouTube. Everything YouTube offers is on their site, including videos. Product videos, product reviews. So people whose business is e-commerce, where website is website, they don't want anybody to go to another website. So contrary to what you would think, you would go and see it for yourself, how different and how much less focus has been put there. Never mind. Now, if you need something like this for internal work, there is a product called Stream, which is a part of Office 365, which I'm sure all of you have if you have Office 365. This allows you to upload videos. There's nothing to do with YouTube. It's a Microsoft product. It's basically using Azure Media Services. It's free. And when you upload a video, it automatically creates transcripts. As of now, only in English and Spanish. More languages will come. If there are faces, it even detects faces and shows you a face timeline. And the transcript is editable and searchable. And typically, if you are using it for training, after training, you do evaluation. So along with the video, you can create a quiz using another tool of Office 365 called Forms. So it then goes on, you see the video passively and then interact. So if you have not seen it, see it. I'm not going to show you. Now this whole thing, if you want to understand how this happens, this is a very sophisticated YouTube analytics. Obviously, I don't have time, but go and explore it there. It's really, really nice. It can be overwhelming, but just go step at a time. And lastly, he's the happiest man when he hears the word lastly. So lastly, if you have more than 10,000 subscribers, you can actually use a physical studio, which is created by YouTube. In India, there is only one, which is in Mumbai, in Film City. So you have to go by appointment, but you are eligible to go and use their production facility. And there are other advisors also sitting there. So bottom line, there is a lot of opportunity. I hope some of it was useful, something gave you ideas, use it to your advantage. That's all we have time for. Thank you.